Kampala, Lord's Mayor Erias Lukwago has urged the government to fulfill its 16 billion shillings pledge meant for the purchase of a garbage dumping site for the Kampala metropolitan area. Lukwago yesterday launched the garbage collection initiative at Kafumbe Mukasa Road in Kampala. He said this campaign will be spread across Kampala City.
Kakugamanti operation clear garbage from the city. Starting with the central business district. Zino mountains, over hills, over ensozi. Ezakasasire zizeze tuma mubulikanyomero kechibuga. Twagala okuzikiriyalinga.
The cleanup campaign is scheduled to last between 7 to 10 days and they hope it will be ample time enough to get rid of the city of piles of garbage. Lukwago added that the city authority is experiencing challenges ranging from the lack of fuel for the garbage trucks as well as uncertainty over the garbage dump sites, among others. Lukwago ever said plans to procure adequate land to serve as a long-term garbage dumping site are underway. He also cautioned the KCCA procurement unit to exhibit transparency in the processes to avoid acquiring land that is contested.
Procurement unit is Sigwafe. Na ye bagenda masu era tubataddeko eriiso joji okulaba ng'omulimu ogwo gukolebwa wansi w'akakiiko ono kaakulembera.
Traders in the city are currently battling with heaps of garbage which they say has impacted the businesses negatively. Vision Group CEO Don Wanyama visited Roofings Limited in Namanve yesterday, meeting with Roofings Group Chairman Sikanda Lalani, Director Oliver Lalani, and other staff members. The visit was aimed at exploring partnership opportunities and strengthening business ties. Roofings Group has operated in the market for about 30 years now, with a total of investment estimated over $400 million in the facility. Since its inception, Roofings has grown to employ over 1,700 staff and is now the largest taxpayer in this industry, according to Oliver Lalani, the director of Roofings Limited.
Currently, Roofings Rolling Mills is earning about $6 to $7 million of export revenue per month. We anticipate that this can increase to up to $9 or $10 million, which is just under 40 billion shillings of export revenues per month. And we've been well recognized for our export contribution to Uganda's economy.
Oliver noted that Roofings was among the first companies to advertise in the New Vision newspaper in 1996. He added that they have undertaken numerous corporate social responsibility initiatives and seek partnerships with other corporations. Wanyama commended Roofings for its economic impact on the national country.
So we're doing really just like you're doing standard, global standard quality products. Our commercial printing is very, very deliberate on quality.
The first delivery of doses of almost 100,000 doses of mpox vaccine will arrive in the Democratic Republic of Congo today, 5th September, and be deployed this weekend, says WHO Director General Tedros Adhanom Ghebreyesus during a press conference in Geneva.
An update on the mpox outbreaks in the Democratic Republic of the Congo and neighboring countries. We expect the first delivery of vaccines to arrive in DRC tomorrow, donated by the European Commission's Health Emergency Preparedness and Response Authority, or HERA. DRC's Ministry of Health plans to begin deploying the vaccines this weekend.
The vast Central African country of around 100 million people is at the epicenter of the mpox outbreak, with cases and deaths rising. More than 17,500 cases and 629 deaths have been reported in the country since the start of the year, according to World Health Organization, WHO. The WHO said at the end of August that around 230,000 MVA-BN vaccine doses produced by the Danish drug maker Bavarian Nordic were imminently available to be dispatched to the affected regions.
I thank the European Union Commission for its donation, and we call on countries with stockpiles of vaccines to work with us and our partners to get those vaccines to where they're needed now.
In Africa, Mpox is now present in 13 countries, including Burundi, Congo-Brazzaville, and Central African Republic, according to figures from the Africa CDC dated August 27th. Outside the continent, the virus has also been detected in Sweden, Pakistan, and the Philippines.